Welcome back. It is time to take a look at what's trending on the web. So, this 10-year-old boy with autism, he decided to build a 26-foot-long replica of the Titanic.
That's all made impressive.
From Legos.
Awesome.
Wow.
Yeah, it's now on display at the Titanic Museum in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee.
Near the Smoky Mountains.
And the
beautiful
ship,
place.
It's made out of 56,000 Legos and took 11 months to build.
Almost a full year.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
And he wanted to make the ship after his trip to Denmark inspired him. During the experience, he learned how to communicate, and he's now excelling at school. So he also now holds a world record.
Very cool. And I love the Titanic. I'm fascinated by it. Of course, today's ships, I mean, are so much larger.
Yeah.
But at the time, Titanic was the largest ship of the world and deemed unsinkable.
Mm-hmm.
Not even God himself could sink the ship, and then it sinks on a maiden voyage.
Yeah.
Now, when
careful
I pass
what you call
Pigeon
down.
Forge, I'm going to have to check this out in the museum.
This is cool. I really like this.
You've been to Pigeon Forge?
Multiple times because Great Smoky Mountains is just my favorite place to go.
I'd love to visit.
Okay, the National Zoo in Washington, D.C. welcomed a baby gorilla Sunday. It's the first gorilla born at the zoo in 9 years. Kalia, one of the zoo's western lowland gorillas, gave birth to a baby boy at 6:25 Sunday night. The baby gorilla's name is Mookie, very cute name there, which means junior or little one in Lingala. The birth holds special significance to both their zoo family and to the critically endangered species as well. Look at that.
Just napping on mom. That is
so,
a good way to be right
cute.
There.
This is great footage. I was telling Megan, I'm always so fascinated when I do go to the zoo to see the monkeys and the gorillas interact so human-like.
They're so funny, too, when you go to the zoo and watch them. I mean, they'll just walk around, throw things at other gorillas.
They're really comical.
They are. They're very silly.
Well, guys, we're very close DNA-wise, and you should see me in the afternoons. I throw things at
you act like a gorilla
around the house.
You monkey around.
I make a lot of noises. Yeah.
Well, it's history in the making for Kendrick Lamar. He is the first rap artist to win a Pulitzer Prize.
This is amazing. Congratulations to him.
The Pulitzer Music Award, it's usually given to works of classical music or jazz, but Lamar's politically charged fourth studio album has just picked up all the awards released back in April of last year. The album features the song Humble, which he's won Grammys for, multiple Grammys, Best Rap Performance, Best Rap Song, and Best Music Video. And he's really one of those artists that I think is just climbing up the ladder because of the topics that he discusses in his music. It's not just about, you know, money and girls and
cars. Oh, he's edgy. He's political, too.
I mean, But the artist he's with, I mean, I was just telling Heidi, he has a song with you two. So it has a twist of hip-hop and then rock.
Yeah, he's really collaborative, and I think that will continue in the future with very good artists. He's out of Compton, you know, Compton, California. Sometimes had a bad reputation. Of course, the Watts riots were there in the 60s. And then, but I remember playing baseball at Compton Community College, and things have changed a lot in Compton. They've improved a lot.
So interesting to hear that you've played baseball there.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
Back in your day.
When I was in high school, I played at Linwood High School, and that's also in Compton. By the way, one of the most famous people to ever graduate from Linwood.
Who?
Famous accordion player, Weird Al Yankovic. That is correct. Weird Al Yankovic went to Linwood High School. Yes.
It's just so interesting because I'm also from California. So for me, like in San Diego, we know Compton is like, you know, not a
rough
good place.
Well-deserved reputation in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, but a lot of money's infused to it, and the homes have been improved.
I think all property
in California has been improved now.
But I just think the gang-related
still some problems.
Yeah, there's still some games
there.
They've
been able to crack down on it a lot better. So it's a much safer place, a much better place to be now.
Okay.
And of course, Kendrick Lamar was influenced by all that growing up, and then the stories he heard and the life he saw as well.
Yeah. And then he includes those stories into his songs, his albums.
Which makes him so relatable for a lot of people. Let's talk weather. It's going to be a warm day today, but might want to put my